Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, draining spiritual stamina. And she said, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he awoke out of his sleep and said, I will go out as other times before and shake myself. And he wist not that the Lord had departed from him. Judges 16:20. Thomas Edison and the light bulb. Edison's invention continues to brighten our world. However, the light bulb is useless unless it is connected to a power or an energy source. The light bulb is designed for a specific purpose, but it does not have the capacity to light up by itself. The bulb must be plugged in with the switch turned on to let the electricity flow through the filament, creating the light. Whenever the power is blocked or disconnected, a perfectly good light bulb will leave you in darkness. Light illuminates darkness. In Matthew 5:14-16, we read, you are the light of the world. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Jesus said that we are the light of the world. Our purpose is to let light shine. The way we live our lives should help people around us see clearly. We bring light into their lives. The darker the night, the brighter the smallest light shines. The Holy Ghost is our power source. A light bulb plugged in, just like Edison's bulb, we will leave the world in darkness unless we remain connected to the source, which is the Holy Ghost. On our own, we are powerless to light up the world. In order for our light to shine, we have to stay connected to the Spirit of God. What makes our light seem to burn out? The switch is turned on, but the light is off. To help us discover this spiritual power loss, look at the life of Samson. Samson, the original Superman. God gave him superhuman strength to lead the nation of Israel and defeat their enemies, the Philistines. Samson seemed to be unstoppable. He was invincible and indestructible. However, Samson's strength was not superhuman. It was supernatural. Samson was empowered by the Spirit. Unfortunately, Samson's story does not have a happy ending. Delilah found out the secret of his strength and cut Samson's hair as he napped on her lap. Samson didn't know the Spirit had left him. Samson would have fought the battle on his own. In Samson's previous exploits, the Spirit of the Lord was with him and helped him. Now, Samson would have to try to overcome his enemies by his own strength. Without God's help, he lost. Child of God, let me tell you, sin makes you stupid. Samson mistook the light of the end of the tunnel, but he didn't hear the train blowing its horn. Wisdom say it's time to run the other way. What is wisdom? Wisdom is knowledge put into action at the right time and in the right way. Wisdom is understanding what is best and doing it all rolled into one. When we have proper understanding of what wisdom is, we can better understand the folly or foolish behavior. The fool takes action without enough information. The fool acts impulsively, not waiting for the right time. The fool knows the truth, but acts upon a lie. How can we maintain spiritual power? Well, I'm glad you asked. By keeping God as our source, by developing wholesome friendships, by living a life of obedience free from compromise, and learn to discern and live a life of wisdom. The thought of the day. The fool takes action without enough information. The fool acts impulsively, not waiting for the right time. The fool knows the truth, but acts upon a lie. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.